three boys, triplets, and two dads. Anhui is kicking off a normal day with his children. But in China, families like theirs aren't the norm. 10 years ago, he met his partner Ye Jianbin. Soon the two men decided they wanted a family together. Here in China, LGBT families are very uncommon. But in 2014, their dream finally came true after a successful round of IVF, or in vitro fertilization, using a surrogate mother.
I think I'll probably have even more children. For example, 10 or 20 more children, anything is possible.
Gaining access to IVF for An and Ye wasn't simple. An and Ye's kids were born from a Thai mother using human eggs provided by a German donor at a hospital in Hong Kong. In China, gay couples have no way to legally use reproductive technologies. So that means if they really want to use IVF, they have to leave the mainland, and that is very expensive. According to one nonprofit surrogacy organization, the average cost of hiring a Thai surrogate is more than $50,000. But not all of China's LGBT couples can afford the high costs of overseas IVF. Duan Rongfeng and his partner Li Tao got married in the US in 2015. And while they'd like kids, they say their income just doesn't stretch that far.
International surrogacy is really expensive. I calculated the cost once and figured I had to sell a house if I wanted a child.
They're also worried about their children facing discrimination in a traditional Chinese society. They even say they dread the idea of explaining having children to their conservative families. Like Duan and Li, both cost and tradition are leaving most same-sex couples in China sitting on the fence about having kids. And until a time when China reforms laws on LGBT couples having kids, it looks like that is where they may have to stay.